this is the magic of little cars. I've never been on this line.
Oh, I see.
Welcome to Big Sound Hobbies. Today I'm going to try to answer the questions, are upgrades in MOS worth it for Axial SCX24? Less than a month ago, I picked up Axial SCX24 1967 Chevrolet C10 Mini Crawler and took it out to my testing ground to see what a stock SCX24 can really do. I was quite impressed with its stock performance and declared it the best mini RC crawler. I saw the potential in it and I started to make some changes to it, focusing on weight distribution. The stock weighed in at 230 grams with 52% front, 48% rear weight distribution. I've been striving towards an ideal weight distribution of 60 front and 40 rear. The first change was to replace the tires and the wheels, then the shock mod, steering mod, ESC and battery relocation, new servo, then finally added some much needed breast weights to the front to get me to the 58% front and 42% rear. It still needs a bit of work to get to the 60-40 weight distribution that I'm looking for, but I wanted to see if the changes have made a difference in performance. I have links to all the upgrades down in the description. They are affiliate links. Use those links to check out whatever is in your cart. Gives a little bit of commission and every little bit helps. Now let's take a look at before and after, which should help answer the question, are upgrades and mods worth it?
Who joined us?
Oh yeah, because he's got the orange one like that.
He's
right?
Charging my defender with his blazer. Alright, game on. Game on. Two against one.
Yeah, we were hoping who was gonna make it out today, but he had something going on.
Yeah,
hey, at least you find yours.
Yeah, so he was super fun. But you gotta see our
I would assume that they're not very good for straight action.
Way, way low.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I would just start with one.
Just get,
Coming down from here?
Yeah, but I never really, I only ran into like 2 minutes in the backyard because I had the predator.
Any lines up there?
I will never get predator compound.
No, the G8s will be good though.
I feel like predator compound is just too fast. Like
right here? See, this is the magic of little cars. I've never been on this line.
Oh, I see. Alright, from this side.
Yeah. Man, Crox has made a winner with that body for sure. Chevy C10.
Yeah.
What's the problem? It's the air.
Yeah, made it.
Oh, dang.
So, what do you think? It's pretty evident that upgraded SX24 performed way better than the stock. It's much more stable and planted. It's able to climb pretty steep stuff, even some 1/10 scale trucks have rough times with. It still needs a bit of fine tuning, but I consider the upgrades and mods so far well worth it. By the way, I'm not a big proponent of adding a lot of rest weights, even down low to help lower the CG. It has a domino effect, so in future upgrade videos, I'll be focusing on reducing weight while trying to get the 60-40 weight distribution that I'm looking for. Hope you found the information helpful. Please like and subscribe and make sure to hit the notification bell to be notified of future videos. Thanks for watching Bigson Hobbies.